All right, chill, Huff. Coming for you. Be a way to increase the heart's power, perhaps by drawing it from the elemental guardians? Their power is incomprehensibly vast, and any one of them could supercharge Ordrak's heart to more than equal the task. But would draining away that energy kill the guardian? Would its associated element then run amok, or vanish altogether? I must spread the donation across multiple guardians. The guardians are unlikely to willingly part with that energy. I must take what I need and pray that there is time for apologies later. My minions. Shit, good shoulders. Those on, for sure. Slide that right in there. Boots, no. Belt, no. Months of research and experiments, I am forced to conclude that my ember blight is incurable, and I am not alone. Hundreds die from it every year. Thousands more must be isolated from ember, lest even the least exposure trigger a psychotic episode. The only real solution, it seems, is to remove the source of the infection, to destroy all ember everywhere. Until now, this has been an unrealistic proposal. But with the defeat of Ordrak, I believe a universal cure to ember blight is finally within reach. Ardrak's heart is itself corrupted and might actually be more dangerous to me than Ember. I've designed and crafted a tool in the form of a stave to control and wield the heart, but it is not enough. The foul energies released by the heart are capable of creating physical and mental deformities, even with only casual exposure. Accordingly, I must construct a suit of ember-resistant armor to shield me from the worst of the effects.
Quest Ember.
Right. Now we can go. These notes are enlightening, to say the least. Clearly, the alchemist is suffering from ember blight-induced dementia. Each subsequent note is more delusional than the last. But, he did wear a suit of armor, and he did wield Ordrak's heart, and he did attack the Guardian of Water. What if there is some nugget of truth in this madness, or in his madness? Pass on that. Pass on that. Good.
I don't have enough mana.
Hurry up and get some.
I don't have enough mana.
Ha!
little.
That one. Let's take that one. Pass on that. And he's full up, so get the
Your
fuck out of here.
Your pet has departed.
Meanwhile, let's throw that in there. And that in there. Why not? Skill mastery, what did that do? No fucking clue. Sword, no.
pet has returned.
I need a golden key. Years in order. I don't even know what the fuck that order is. Obviously not second. Shit. Holy crap. That is a lot of gold. More gold. Nice. Alright. Fuck. Got a lot of stuff. Desert mantle of health. Ooh. That's good. I like that. That one. An identify bow. Nah. Pass on that. Although, well, it's a good bow. But. See, the helm. Pass. The shillelagh. Pass. Mighty Asterian shoulders. Pass. Fortified patchwork mitts. No. No. Alright, what do we got here? Regent pants. No. Alright. Although, let's throw some of these out. Oh, that's the... Alright. Okay, cool. So we'll come back to that one. Seen those guys before.
Your task is complete.
And for that, I need to go all the way back over there. Yes, those are the crusts. Yes, those are the three crusts. Now, allow me a moment to fit them together. I see. Yes. Yes! The Asterians hid the golden gear in a small cave not so far from here. No. No. Yes. Definitely yes on that one. Alright, well, let's finish exploring this. There's some spots here I haven't covered yet, and we'll come back to it. Should be completely explored now. Here we go. The Spring Cave.